Let's ride, y'all. I'm finna fire this bitch up. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome, world. Black nation. Black first always. Welcome to out there in North America, South America, Central America, all through the Americas, all through the world. World, welcome to my Melanoid nation. This is going to be like a special edition of Coon Hunters Thursday on this Thanks for Nothing edition. Or Genocide Day, as I call it, because I don't even celebrate this bullshit. You know, this is once again your gracious and humble servant here, humble host here, Mr. O, the original Black Knight, the triple OG, running back again and raising hell and putting the lance through all these haters. And anybody that followed me and subscribed to me know what I do best when it comes to Thursdays. Oh, yeah. Got it restocked, reloaded, got a brand new red dot with a magnifier on that bitch. Coon Hunters Thursday. And once again, I would like to say I'd like to apologize to my subscribers for me being in a hiatus so long because I was doing some upgrades. And now those have been taken care of and we can shall continue. But as I've always do, I've keep my antenna always to the streets on what's going on, particularly to the streets. And first thing first, let me give a shout out. Shout out to Ervin V. Griffin. Shout out to Prince GMO. Them my two buddies right there, my two partners in crime. And also shout out to TicketTV and Town Business JS. And also shout out to 1LVZ, man. Because this shit really, really, really bugged me. Because, see, all I've been hearing all this week about how fuck-ass Stephen A. Smith been... And it's not only Stephen A. Smith, he ain't the only coon that's on my hit list. You know, also that Boule Bird, too, Roland Martin as well. But now, I hardly even get at the bed winches. Now, I could easily go ahead and eat the Raven Simone. I could easily eat the Stacey Trash. I could easily eat the crystal muddy, dirty, filthy, mosquito-infested waters. I could easily go ahead and eat that other Tea Party bitch, Dina Borelli, as well as the coon David Webb. All over there in FAUX News. But now it's a new motherfucker now. It's a new motherfucker that's got my attention. Let me get a drum roll, please. Sage Steele. This bitch has been coming up on my news feed a lot. And I heard Ticket and Town Business them been talking about this hoe. I say, let me go ahead and get at them. Also, shout out to Taurine Rain too, man. And I say, let me go ahead and do some research on this heifer. I caught a glimpse of it on YouTube of her going out here, how she throw out here throwing black men up under the bus and talk and black athletes under the bus and stuff. And you know, like I said, I really don't appreciate it, because these coons and these bed winches are really, really starting to piss me off, man. You know, and I started to look into this, and this is an article that came on the Shadow League, and it was right there on my, and this article was printed right on my birthday, November 18th. Yeah, you know, I'm still turned up, man. You know, 48 years young, I ain't complaining. Solar, happy solar returns to me. You know, shout out to Red Pill and Blue Pill, and shout out to Sonetta them too. Shout out to Brother Billy Dumel, Brother Ismail Bay, shout out to them. This bitch Shay Steele, let me just read this to you. This is coming from the Shadow League here, and I'm just gonna read this to you about her, and I'm gonna just come back with my commentary, because the title of it is Sage Steele is All in Her Feelings. Now, in case y'all know who Sage Steele is, she's an anchor for news, sports, and all this stuff. Particularly NBA and all that. Okay. And it has nothing to do with us. After reading and rereading Sage Steele's Facebook post, yes, she got a Facebook page, and who doesn't? It's clear that the only person who struggles with diversity is her. In a meandering and often confusing message, she accused black people of rejecting diverse viewpoints. It's an odd accusation, given that we really don't know what her views are beyond the national anthem, which is why we're discussing her in the first place. Steele receives harsh pushback for challenging Tampa Bay Buccaneers wideout Mike Evans on Twitter for protesting the national anthem last week. In case y'all don't know who Mike Evans is, you know, he took a knee after he found out that Donald Trump got elected won the presidency. And I think that was, and on Mike Evans, I think that was kind of hypocritical and BS on his part too. Now all of a sudden he wanted to go ahead and take a knee and protest national anthem. Shit, now you want to piggyback on something that Colin Kaepernick firmly stands and believes on. I don't care too much about him either. You know, her tweet included a photo of a man paying his respects at a tombstone in Arlington National Cemetery, a clear indication that she read Evans' protest as an insult to those who served in America's armed forces. She asked him to, quote-unquote, look up the definition of the word democracy and implore him to think of the photo when he decides to kneel. Okay, let me just stop right here for one moment, please. Number one, this dumb bitch don't even know the word of democracy. Democracy, Democrat, that's basically breaking down, deciphering words. Because if you know of your studies in Morris science, they teach you about entomology, the deciphering of words. Democracy, Democrat, one of the same. The Democrat, okay? Mob rules. There is no democracy here. Never has been. It says there in the preamble of the Constitution. It's a republic. Dumb bitch. God. Anyway, Evans eventually caved and said that he will not protest again. Bitch, faggot ass motherfucker. Yeah, because he wasn't genuine with it, of course. He didn't double down, triple down, quadruple down like Colin Kaepernick did or any of the other brothers who really doing it. But I doubt that he thought it through in the first place, but that's a different story. Mike Evans just needs to just shut up, man. You know, the reactions to her tweets were most unkind, and Steele detractors have called her a sellout, coon, and other words unsuitable for print. Well, the latter is perfect for her. I would use the term bedwench as well. Some even suggest that her conservative views were to be expected because of her quote-unquote her marriage to a white man. You know, even though he is Irish. But he got his honorary white card, though. Those personal attacks were wrong and unnecessary, but so was her follow-up response on Facebook. Instead of expounding on her disagreement with Evan's protests and opened up a dialogue that respected his agency and those who refused to stand during the national anthem, she wrote a perplexing note lamenting black people's closed-mindedness on the subject of racial inclusion, particularly interracial relationships, a.k.a. swirling. See, she ain't no better than that other heifer, the other slack-jawed heifer, Kerosene Napalm, or whatever the hell her last name is, who was on Google Hangouts crying because the white dude dissed her. Anyway, let me continue. Instead of shaming her for marrying a white man, we should be praising that white boy from Indiana who followed his colorblind heart, she argues. And she makes a point of uplifting her white mother for the grief she experienced after marrying her black father. Fresh off of the tumultuous civil rights era. That, Steele argues, is a perfect example of our wonderful diversity. It's as he feels her mother's marriage was an act akin to Rosa Parks refusing to give up her seat on the bus, or someone who sacrificed their body on Bloody Sunday. It's clear to me that, you know, she wants cool points for centering whiteness and is puzzled over why someone isn't enthusiastic about America as she is. More insulting, Steele wants us to celebrate her white mother, who is more privileged than most of the black Americans she is criticizing. After all, the racist attacks that have taken place after Donald Trump's victory 3 weeks ago have been directed at people of color, not folks who look like the white boy from Indiana she married. So Steele is not really asking us to embrace diversity. She's insisting that we celebrate whiteness. Now, her post also suggests that black people are resistant to interracial marriage, even though research proves that black millennials are just as fine with it as their white peers. Black people between the ages of 50 and 65 even more so. Now, a Gallup poll found that black people have been more accepting of interracial marriages than whites since 1969, when the poll started tracking such data. I'm sure some black people have responded negatively towards her marriage, but it's fair to say that most of us really don't care. But she clearly thinks we do. You check out her Facebook post, comes off as she's really processing some unresolved pain about her identity and choice to marry outside of her race, and in turn, decides to project her frustrations on us. Even though she admits her white grandparents, not the black ones, objected to her parents' union. You know, we don't, quote-unquote, get a hall pass because you're a minority, she still wrote. True, but you don't get cool points for being the exception, Negro, while distancing yourself from the travails of being black either. Stupid ass. Her entire colorblind tone comes across as she's above taking on racism in the radical ways Evan chose. It is too un-American for her taste, obviously. Oddly, her note declined to articulate, my apologies, darn doggone notifications, articulate a similarly robust appraisal of the racism that has Evans and other athletes protesting in the first place. She never takes white people to task, just black folks. I wonder why. Maybe she doesn't see the racism that has compelled people like Evans and more consistently and stoically and forcefully and locked uply Colin Kaepernick to take a knee. Or perhaps Steele's love for country reigns so supreme that she fails to appreciate Americans who conscientiously objects his flaws. Such a view is not champion diversity. That's just plain blind. All right. Now, let's get into it. This buttermilk head bitch pissed me the fuck off. You know I'm about to sound off on this shit. Hey, shout out to Angelia Hines. Yeah, the chat room is open, man. Angelia always coming through. She got her brother's back as always like this. Welcome to my show. Yeah, I know Angelia. She's delusional as fuck. That's why, you know, I mean, see, she's one of those type of bedwitch coons. See, this is a real life Olivia Pope in a way. But the problem is, she's like a female version of Stephen A. Smith, using her platform to go ahead and trash black athletes and throw them under the bus just to satisfy white daddy. I can't stand that shit. Especially from some broad like here that look like Herman Monster. You know, I get so tired of this shit. And on top of that, she down with the swirling. Now, I also have a picture of her immediate family with her white boy from Indiana, her husband, and stuff. You can, I'll post that up in my Twitter feed, and you'll see the picture right there. You know, this woman here, she is the perfect example of a bed wench. Although she favors Stacey Trash older sister, but who's counting? You know. But what you call them? Here's a little bit of good news though. I'm reading off here that
but anyway, this monkey.
You know, and shout out to Miko Grimes, man, for bringing. Bringing this to my attention, man. One LIVZ for bringing this to my attention. You know, because she basically, because they had a Twitter beef, and like I said, she smashed that bed wench. Let me just read it to you from a Twitter feed, and I'm gonna just go in right here. Get ready to laugh, people. Okay. Because on the Amazing Show, it's always explicit. Ain't nothing filtered here. I'm just giving it to you straight. It's like Grandma Ye. I give it to you straight, no chaser. This bitch, Stay Still, had nothing to say when Riley Cooper called black people niggers because she thinks she's not black because she sucked white dick. For those that ain't hear me, let me read that shit again. This bitch Stay Still had nothing to say when Riley Cooper, in case y'all don't know who Riley Cooper was, his Peckerwood ass still play for the Philadelphia Eagles. Wide receiver who was at a Kenny Chesney concert, and the black security guard wouldn't let him back there and stuff, and had to push him off, and he was caught on video and audio saying, "Man, I'll fight every nigger out here and stuff." Who come up there to take up for him? Not only Stephen A. Smith, but also the other coon too, that's got a permanent coon train membership, Deion Sanders. But I'ma jump on his ass later. Right now, I gotta go at this hoe. Yeah, call black people niggas because she think she ain't black because she suck white dick. And she also had to say this bitch had nothing to say about Snyder still having his job while the water in Flint still was dirty. Bitch, you a fucking coon. Need I say more? You know, Ash plus on top of that, she got some more to say about that. Miko Grimes, in case y'all don't know, she is the wife of, used to be, NFL cornerback Brent Grimes, who played here for the Miami Dolphins here at that time. You know. And then here goes some other stuff that she went her ass about. Told her, said, I bought titties that look better than hers too, so she doesn't have the upper hand there either. Just admit, black skin is unattractive to you. Shoot. And she also said, racist white men, Kate Upton does not look better than me. That bitch look dead without makeup, and she's shaped like a Samsung charger. Stop. Oh my goodness. Ooh, boy, she went in on this heifer. I mean, straight smashed her. But the thing like with Sage Steele, she has this personal hatred of black men and stuff like that because of her doubt, saying she diversity and all this shit, saying now she doing this Tiger Woods shit that she one fourth white, this and that like that. Bitch, you black. I don't even know why the hell you even took these guys, these people that try to get out here and deny their heritage. Just like how they deny the fact that you know, you don't want to say black, which I'm about to jump on somebody else. I'm going to get on Sage Steele later. I got to hit up this idiot, you know, Roland Martin. Isn't that right, Roland Martin? Boule Bird. You did all that buck dancing and stuff for Killery to try to get her in there. Went so far as to go ahead and sneak her the debate questions to Donna Brazile that end up getting her canned from CNN. Because she thought he was going to have him a nice little job that he was in. Because the only reason he's doing TV, none. And so he auditioned so he can get his old job back at CNN. So he ain't fooling nobody, really. So, you know, and then, like, I don't know if anybody caught it, that Roland Martin had the alt-left president of the NPI, whatever, Richard Spencer, you know, and I listened to that cat too, that, you know, I can't really take that clown seriously either. You know, I don't have, let me see if I have the audio to it. Jason Black had pointed that out too. You have to see it on his Facebook page. You see that video there, it's a little snippet up there where he asks Roland Martin, because see, thing with Roland Martin, see, he gets his kicks off to try to think like, you know, he's smarter than everybody else that by going ahead and debating these idiots and inviting them on the show. You would invite a white nationalist on what's supposed to be a black syndicated news station. And this man came flat out and asked you, are you a black man? And Roland Martin kept repeating, I'm a man, I'm a man, and I'm a Christian. What the fuck? Roland Martin lost his goddamn mind. Either that or he wearing them damn ascots around his neck too damn tight. Blood ain't going to his head. I mean, when I saw that, I had to go back and I had to look back at it twice, family. And, yeah, Angela, yeah, she's shaped like a Samsung charger. For everybody who doesn't, that has a Samsung Galaxy phone, if you're in an NBA game and Sage Steele is there, please, you can charge your phone up by going to her. She ain't too hard to find. She's shaped like a Samsung charger. I'm just letting you know. Oh, God, Jesus, I tell you. Why I said that? Anyway, back to Boule Bird. You know, Dr. Wobble. God, Jesus, I tell you. Why you think every black person got a wobble? you know, it makes you wonder, why in the world are you going to invite this fool? This proves more and more that the old black media is dead. See, the new black media is basically the black channel with Jason Black, Professor Black Truth, Mona Lachey. New black media includes people, allies like Mr. Superboy 223, J. Miller Speaks, The Advise Show, Ervin V. Griffin, okay, Kimberly Frazier, The Amazing Show. And see, here's one common denominator with all us, Roland Martin. We don't give a shit about fame. We ain't trying to come on to TV One. We ain't trying to come on your show. I don't give a damn about that. Because all of us, we speak because we speak for the streets. And you coons and you bed wenches and you buck dancing sambos, y'all need to be dealt with and dealt with diligently. Real talk. See, now all of a sudden, like Red Pill said, y'all want to get out here, you want to grow wings, and then now you want to fly south. Y'all want doing all this shit, but you want to ride for Hillary. You want to ride for the Clintons. The Clinton crime cartel. That's the real triple C's. Not Rick Ross them, no. The real triple C is the Clinton crime cartel. But I don't want to go off base, off topic here, though. But, you know, like I said, shout out to LVZ. Shout out to J-Town, to Town Business JS. Shout out to TicketTV, man, because, you know, about this Sage Steele and getting back on this health and all that. She's a female version of Stephen A. Smith. She's out here. She's throwing black athletes under the bus and, you know, going ahead and attacking Mike Evans and all that stuff. But see, I don't care nothing about Mike Evans because Mike Evans wasn't true to what he did. He did that, took a knee one time because he felt like that was a trend, or he was just being a dumbass because Donald Trump won the election and he's going to be the next president. So he wasn't really truthful to it. You know what I'm saying? Because, see, he likes the fact he's still getting the $1 million check. He likes the fact that he can still jump in his drop-top Bentley or Rose Phantom or whatever. He likes the fact he can go ahead and drive 45 minutes from Tampa Bay to Miami Beach, and come to the club live on a Sunday night and make it rain. Or whatever the hell y'all try to do. And then you know, leave out of there with some Becky. I swear, some of these guys really get me. That's why I say, man, he never got my respect. Fuck Mike Evans, and fuck Stage Steele too. But you know what? This heifer here, this bed wench here needs her nigga moment. You know what I'm saying? She needs her real nigga moment right about now. You know. Fuck she know about diversity. She about to confuse. She doing that Tiger Woods shit. I'm 1/4 this, I'm 1/2 that, and all this stuff. I say, okay, I tell you what. Let's go to a Klan rally. I'll leave your ass there and see what happens. Shit, your white boy husband ain't gonna help you, Miss Sage. This old Skeletor looking ass merman, beast man, trap jaw looking motherfucker. Please. I don't know, man. It's like, it just really makes me sick to my core. You know. When we trying to go ahead and do something like this, because I keep saying this and I say I'm going to keep saying it. Till the cows come home. The cooning ain't gonna save you. It really not. Shoot. Isn't that right, Floyd Mayweather? Isn't that right, Layla Ali? Isn't that right, Lil Wayne? Isn't that right, Ray Lewis? Jason Whitlock? Huh? Shaq? Charles Barkley? Larry Elder? Jesse Lee Peterson? Herman Cain? Cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, Clarence Thomas. Cam Newton. You damn right, Andrew. White folks can have their asses. The same thing go for these bed witches too. Sage Steele is probably the epitome of it. She wants to include white inclusion and all that. Basically want to try to tell some of these misguided sisters who lost, thinking like, oh, a black man ain't good enough for him. The best thing is for him is a white man. She probably only married only with him because of money. That's about it. And the same thing go for these some of these misguided brothers who want to go ahead and chase after Beckys and stuff. I ain't got time for that. Shoot. But at the end of the day, yeah, like this, I'll be real with you. I'm a man too. And if I see a woman that look nice, I'm going to give them props where it give them. You know, I don't care who they are. But when it come down to the romance, when it come down to buckling down, tripling down, or putting it down, I got to do it with a sister. Straight up. And that sister got to be real. Because see, a brother get with a sister, a real sister, you get, quote unquote, like Red Pill said, get turned up. I don't know not one brother that's with a Becky that got turned up. Name me five right now, if you can. Go ahead, I'll wait. Reason speaking? Nah, you can't. Because see, guess what? They end up getting weaker. Everything in this era, everything you do in this plane is about energy. Giving energy, receiving it, and taking it. But see, you get with a sister, get with that Shaniqua or Shakisha or Laquina or Latasha. excuse me, I'm sorry. I'm saying like that. You end up, brother get turned up. He become more stronger. In other words, he become a better man. Now, I know it's probably going to be some troll that's probably on YouTube right now. Probably going to say, oh, well, that's just being racist, Mr. Ho. You just being racist. Y'all saying like that. We all the same. We all people. We all this. No, the fuck we not. No, the fuck we not. But I'm going to say that for another show when it come down to it. But that's the type of agenda that Sage Steele is doing. And she's also put there for a reason. Because she's dangerous, y'all. She's got a platform to operate from to spew this vitriol that she's spewing. To go ahead to protect her white daddy. And see, that's how these coons are. That's how these bed wenches are. You think Sally Hemings had a choice with Thomas Jefferson being the pedophile that he is? Raped her multiple times? It's no different than it is when you look at the porn flicks. Like, what's the name of that shit, that ghetto gagger shit? Somebody sent me a link to that chunk, and I seen, and it showed even them doing dudes. I said, hell no, that I turned that bullshit off. But yet though, these are the type of barbarians, hairback barbarians that Sage Steele and Stacey Dash and that Mio chick and that Dina Borelli's, these the type of them bed wenches want to lay up with. But then you're gonna have some old peckerwood gonna come out saying, you N-words just mad because white get it right. Oh, please. You think we sweating that? Me and Irv Griffin were talking about that. You think we sweat that? If you want her, you can have her. We don't sweat that. I live down here. I'm from Miami, Florida. And the cultural diversity here is like, shoot, you got more interracial dating and interracial relationships here in South Florida than anywhere else. New York can't even touch this because of the many different ethnicities and nationalities that live, work, and play here. So I don't even know where they come from. I'm pretty sure a troll that'll say that is probably over there from Stormfront. I don't even pay their punk asses no mind. I give them a piece of my mind and I block their ass and keep it moving because I'm all about nation building. Angela, yes, you're right. You know, yeah, those crackers, they overrated as hell because, like, I don't want to go on a porn tip like this because look all the shit they got to do. They try to go ahead to get the major wood that they want, and they can't. When in truth and reality, they have nothing more than just a little twig. They go by through implants, Viagra, all this other chemically enhanced bullshit. They even go so far as to go ahead here and go stealing dead black men's sex organs. Oh, yeah. They do more than just harvesting hearts and livers and all this stuff and like that. They harvest also the genitalia, too. That's just like how these barbarians get down. Okay? That's just how these crackers get down like that. But yet, though, it's broads like Stage Steele and Stacey Dash and all this other shit. Whoopi Goldberg, too. They want to lay up with this piece with trash like that. But as soon as they start berating them, just like a YouTube video where Trump got elected, you know, this sister, she had living with a white guy. And how he was on there just openly came out saying nigga this, nigga that, talking about Black Lives Matter, blah, blah, blah. She just sat there calmly and just basically audio recorded his ass. Well, I'm here to report, thank God, that she left his ass unscathed. That's just it, you know. And yeah, and Roland Martin, dude, you basically made an ass out yourself when you were buck dancing for Hillary, and then she lost. Now you looking up like an ass up shit creek. All your prospects of trying to be somewhere went up in smoke. And then you brought this little lily-livered, leave it to beaver looking motherfucker Richard Spencer of alt left on your shit, and that man came asked you flat out, are you a black man? He's saying, I'm a man, I'm a Christian. Proof more right there, family, that the old black media is dead. New black media is on the rise. Black channel, that's where it's at. Okay, you know, I'm getting really a pounding headache right now with these coons and these bed wenches. They're making me sick to my goddamn stomach. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to post that video in my Twitter feed. You can follow me on Twitter, Amin Ra 7. That's Amin, capital A, M-E-N, underscore, capital R-A, underscore 7 on Twitter. You can follow me right through there and stuff. I might post it like that on Periscope too as well, just to let you know. So definitely like that. And yeah, the live broadcasts are soon gonna be coming to Skype. So that's in the works too. So that's later on down the line. But that's not enough about with me. So That's the thing, like with them. But let me go ahead here. I'm gonna do. I just wanted to go ahead and get that out. First thing first, let me just give a shout out. Shout out to TicketTV, man, for bringing this to my attention, and Town Business JS too, man. But shout out mostly to LVZ, man, for bringing this to my attention as well. Shout out to Ervin V. Griffin. Shout out to Prince GMO. Shout out to Taurine Rain, Mr. Superboy 223, J. Miller Speaks, Kimberly Frazier, D. Advise Show. Shout out to one of my subscribers, Mr. C.R. Berry. And shout out to all my other subscribers as well via YouTube. This once again, this is the Triple OG. This is the real Black Knight, South Florida style, Miami style, Liberty City style, Mr. O. We going ahead, we getting out of here. Shoot, that concludes my show for the night. Tomorrow, yes, I will be on tomorrow. So, with that said, I'm out. Let's roll, y'all. How y'all doing, y'all? This is Mr. O here, host of The Amazing Show. If you want to, you can always check out my shows by downloading the app Spreaker. If you got iOS, Apple, you got an iPhone, iPad, you know, you can download it through iOS, through the App Store. And if you have Android, say like a Samsung Galaxy, doesn't matter, LG, Motorola, HTC, whatever, you also download it from the Play Store. It's the yellow star that says podcast. That's the Spreaker app. Download that and then type in search The Amazing Show. And there, right there, you can subscribe right there to it. Plus, I also broadcast live via YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Tumblr, as well as SoundCloud. But you can also, from Spreaker, you can download any of my past episodes or current ones. So with that said, thank y'all for coming and attending The Amazing Show. And I promise you, I will bring you the best content ever. Let's just keep it like that. Black first.